Hi, I'm Christi Friesen, and today I want to talk to you about Swellegant. Now, you might not have heard of this product yet, and if you haven't, let me tell you, I'm about to open up a whole new door in your creative house of fun things for you to play with. Now, Swellegant is a line of products, and it's composed of metals, patinas, dyes, and sealant. And I'll explain all of that, what it is, but it's a whole product line, and you're going to want all of it. And because it's sometimes easy to try small doses, I also have a little tiny mini set. So it's a great way to kind of see what the product does for you. Now let's take just a little look at some of the things that Swellegant can change. So essentially what you're doing is you're taking this pulverized metal, you're painting it onto surfaces, and then you're either coloring it or aging it. And it goes on everything. So for example, paper, if you've got a little paper box, look, it doesn't that look like it's made out of metal? And it's all Swellegant. Metal obviously can be changed by Swellegant to add other dye colors or just different colorations, patinas, just little variations to your metals that you may already have. But what about leather? You can put it on leather. It's flexible, it's non-flaking. Fabric, same thing. So let's say you're a doll maker, you wanted to have a Roman guy with a full armor on, you make it out of pleather or something like that, it can look like it's made out of actual metals, which is pretty exciting. I'm a polymer person, so I do a lot of stuff out of polymer, and you can see the majority of these pieces are polymer. So you've taken something that's an inexpensive, lightweight material, made it look like aged metal, which is freaking great. And then we've got things like shells, fantastic on shells, and some studio, or I should say gallery wire there, just an assortment as you can see. And look at all the range that you get. So you basically have this pulverized metal that you put on, you use your patinas to make it look aged, and then you have 13 different dyes to change the color and add all kinds of gloriousness to it. And then finally, there's a sealer, because when you're all done, you don't want that dyes and patinas to transfer onto you or your clothing, so we have a sealant that will protect it and make it long-lasting. So doesn't that sound like fun? Don't you just want to get started at putting this metal Swellegant on everything in your studio? Well, stick around, because I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. So let's just talk tools and supplies. As you can tell, you really do not need much to play with Swellegant. Most important thing is gloves. The dye is dye, and you will have dye all over you if you don't wear some gloves, so that's always a must. And you need something like a paper towel or towels to clean up or dab brushes in, which brings us to brushes and water. We'll use that quite a lot. I like a little mister bottle, both for the dyes and the patinas. That's nice to have around. I like a heat gun because I get impatient and I want things to dry quickly. So having one of those around is not a must, but it's definitely a good thing. And then when you're done and you're doing the finishing things, having some soft sponges and even a brass brush, very, very helpful to kind of take away that top coating of patina and expose the metal. But I will tell you all about that. All you need to know is this is the sorts of things you should have around when you're getting ready to play with all of the wonderful Swellegant projects that I'm going to show you.
Visit our Learning Center at cooltools.us for more cool jewelry making videos. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and be sure to sign up for our email list to be the first to hear about new videos, new products, and other cool stuff from Cool Tools.